Well, joining us now is Joseph Fisher. He works for Cup Prop Rentals. Welcome, Joe.
Good evening. Thank you for having me.
You're welcome, sir. First, the union is quoted as saying there was a live round, not a blank in the prop gun that was fired. So how could this have happened?
That is a very serious mistake for anybody to make on set. Typically, we take precautions to make sure that there's no live ammunition ever near a film set.
So, Joe, walk us briefly through the protocols to make sure that these types of stunts involving prop guns are safe.
Typically, any time a gun is involved in a motion picture or television shoot, there's several safety steps that we take. First is inspecting the weapon before it's even brought to set, making sure that there's no live ammunition with it or anywhere near it the entire time it's packed, transferred, and brought onto set. Once it's on set, that weapon is secured by the armor under most circumstances, and it only leaves that armor's possession long enough to introduce it to the actor, practice, rehearse, and then film the scenes. And then it is immediately returned back to the armor.
Wow, sounds like so many steps are supposed to be taken. Now, Joe, you have samples of what blanks and real bullets look like up close. Can you tell us about them?
Yes, I do. What I have here, let me get it into frame here for you.
There you go.
That is a blank piece of ammunition. As you can see, it's one solid piece, front to back. What I have in my other hand is a live piece of ammunition. Mm-hmm. You can see that there are distinct differences in the shape and dimensions. Mm-hmm. Typically, with a blank piece of ammunition, there'll be a small wadding at the tip. That wadding could be either wax, paper, or some other permeable substance that holds a little charge of gunpowder inside above the primer. There is usually no projectile with that. However, the paper wad or that wax wad can be expelled when the blank round is fired. And if you're within 15 to 25 feet, you could be struck by the debris that comes out of the barrel.
So, Joe, we have seen deadly accidents on movie sets before, but how did the tragedy of actor Brandon Lee change the industry to where it is now?
That was a very tragic incident, which brought a huge spotlight to safety. And it brought an emphasis to having professional armorers and weapon handlers on set. That circumstance, there were a lot of errors that just compounded and resulted in a fatal accident on that set. The weapon was improperly prepared for the set. There was debris inside the barrel when they loaded it with the blanks. And there was a lot of horseplay going on, which contributed to the incident.
Okay, and that was 1993, if I'm
yes.
correct. So, Joe, given the time since that happened, and I don't want to put everything together, but, you know, we're just reporting on what we're hearing as well as far as the crew walking off the set or what have you. How rare is it for something like this to happen on a movie set?
It's not often that it happens. It does occasionally happen where there's a disagreement that is at the level where it cannot be negotiated between the producers, the directors, and the crew, or there's something that occurs that is so erroneous that the crew feels no other option. I've experienced that maybe twice in my career.
So, Joe, do you think there should be anything done to change how we deal with prop guns on sets?
Anytime there's an accident or an incident involving props that result in a serious injury or a death, the entire industry takes a moment. We overlook what we do for safety, where we're doing good, and where we need to make significant improvements. And this is definitely going to be one of those situations.
Yeah, no question, unfortunately so too. Joseph Fisher, thanks so much for joining us and giving us some insight this evening.
My pleasure.